Welcome back to NACA National Tournament. Game between Lancaster Christian and New Covenant. New Covenant out of Lynchburg, Virginia. Lancaster from Tennessee over near Nashville. Before we get started, let me remind you to promote the game is on through social media, text message, give a phone call, let a friend, family member know the game is on the air. Also, we want to remind you to check out our sponsors, Bryan College here in Dayton, Tennessee, Pensacola Christian College in Pensacola, Florida, Score International in Chattanooga, and 323 Sports based in North Carolina.
All right, set to begin this Division 4 matchup. Serve from Allie Kittrell, and we're underway. Lancaster in those blue uniforms to your right. To the left is New Covenant. Is that blocked up front by Emmy Bibb, the 5'8 senior? And Lancaster will serve here, and doing those duties will be Gina Roberts, freshman.
Bailey Barrett entered the game for Lancaster.
That's played to the far side, sent across there by Collins. Now back to your side. And that put down by Caton Binkings. 2-0 the lead for Lancaster, and again, Gina Roberts to serve. That's into the net. So it's 2-1 Lancaster. Abby Ashcroft now to serve for New Covenant out of Lynchburg, Virginia.
Katie Stanley in for Lancaster, Lady Knights.
Serve here, played now up front, set to the outside, tipped down by Keaton Binkley. And it is a 3-1 lead for Lancaster. And Keaton will serve. Serve here. Played now up front by Kittrell. Back row that hit out of bounds by Sarah Gillespie. And it's now a 4-1 lead for Lancaster. The winner of this game advances to the Division 4 Championship, which is literally right after this game.
Wow.
So, for somebody, they're going to be playing a lot of volleyball. This hit into the net by Caton Binkley, and it will be serve for New Covenant here. They trail 4-2. Abby Hall with a line drive serve. It turned on one hit, and a 5-2 lead for Lancaster.
This New Covenant team out of Lynchburg is a member of the VACA conference there. Play teams such as Timberlake and Westover.
Serve here, played now to that back line, dumped across by Gillespie. Back near side, set over by Cassidy Mortensen. This hit deep and out of bounds, and a 6-2 lead for Lancaster. Well, after this, it will be all championship games. The last four games of the day are all championships. There's an ace, and now an 8-2 lead.
Well, looks like we have our first sign of the tournament put up over in the stands today. Mm-hmm. Someone for the Lady Knights entering the game for New Covenant, number 6, and that would be Olivia Hicks.
Apparently, it's only 7-2. Whoever's on that scoreboard is lightning fast. This played down far side, put across by Sarah Gillespie. Back to your side. It's a set over by Mortensen. Now Lancaster will play it again to the outside. Tipped across there by Bailey Barrett. And again, sent right back over. This pumped across there by Tucker. This played off the net. Now bumped back over by Bigley. And that into the net. And it will be a point for Lancaster. And now they lead it 8-2. So the serve here played straight up. Now back line. That hit out of bounds. by Abby Hall, and continuing to serve will be Emmy Bibb, and we have a timeout to New Covenant. 9-2 the lead for Lancaster here in game one. Take a break, back here in just a moment. So out of the timeout, Emmy Bibb, a 5'8 senior, will serve here for Lancaster. Bibb serve, tracked down, now pumped over. At near side, and there's a kill for Cassidy Mortensen. It's 10-2 Lancaster.
We had a little present brought to us before this game, a bottle of Spark from our cameraman, Elmer Harris. Want to say thank you to him for doing that.
And Emmy Bibb with the serve here, set back across by Mortensen. And tipped over here by Allie Kittrell. And dumped back across by Bibb. And this goes off the shoulder of Katie Stanley. And a 10-3 lead for Lancaster. Back to serve for New Covenant is Olivia Hicks. By the way, New Covenant just played the match before this in town. Came out here immediately following that to play this match. And if they were to win this match, they would immediately play the next match.
Wow.
That's asking an awful lot.
Sounds like we ought to give them our bottle of Spark.
Right. That's about right. And the serve here from Katie Stanley is an ace, and it's 12-3 Lancaster. Stanley serve into the net, makes it 12-4. And Sarah Williams will get set to serve here for New Covenant. Played out front by Bibb. Now sent across by Tucker. Back to the way it comes, right back to Lancaster. Tucker back in the middle. And Cassidy Mortensen couldn't quite handle it. So it's 12-5 Lancaster. Sarah Williams with the serve, return on one hit. Sets the outside, tipped across there by Laura Hart. And that's into the net. So 13-5, the lead for Lancaster.
Lancaster's from Smyrna, Tennessee. That would be just east of Nashville, southeast of Nashville, going toward Murfreesboro.
Tucker with the serve. Set back middle of the floor and tipped far side by Abby Ashcroft. 13-6 now the lead for Lancaster. And Laura Hart will serve for New Covenant. Let's serve. Play now up front, somehow saved on the far side by Mortensen. That hit out of bounds. That's 14-6.
John, I'm going to give you a break. I'm not going to ask you anything about Smyrna or Lynchburg this game. How about that?
And I think, I mean, I know a little bit about Lynchburg, of course, Liberty being there, a few other things. I know some about Smyrna, too. I've been through there a few times. That tipped into the net by Abby Ashcroft. So 15-6 the lead for Lancaster. Serve here by Cassidy Mortensen. Return. And sent back across by Emmy Bibb. Battle at the net, and it's won by Lancaster, and they lead it 16-6.
Coming in for New Covenant, number 33, Emily Weatherholt.
Serve from Mortensen. And back out front, tipped across by Allie Kittrell, and 16-7 Lancaster.
Olivia Hicks coming back in the game for New Covenant now.
Kittrell's serve played off the ceiling by Gina Roberts, and it's 16-8. Serve here from Kittrell, clips the net but still goes over. Pumped across by Binkley. On the outside, and a kill for Abby Hall, and it's 16-9. Lancaster with the lead. Serve from Cottrell. Now played over to Keaton Tucker, who puts it across. Now Lancaster back to the near side. That tip into the net. And now finally sent over by Roberts. And turned here by Stanley. Set to the outside. Abby Hall for New Covenant. That's returned. Hall again hits it into the net. And it's 17-9 lead.
Bailey Barrett coming into the game now for Lancaster.
Serve here from Roberts is an ace. Make it 18-9. And a timeout. 18-9, the lead for Lancaster over New Covenant. We're in the middle of game one. We're back with more of that in just a minute. Serve here, played by New Covenant out of the timeout. Pumped across by Williams. Now Lancaster with it. And a kill for Keaton Binkley, and it's now a 19-9 lead for Lancaster.
Weatherholt back in the game for New Covenant.
Serve from Gina Roberts. And finally bumped across. Good. Sent over by Binkley. That's it back up front. And this set across. Now set up from Lancaster. Just put over there by Binkley. And it's pumped across. Tracked down by Weatherholt. And that hit far side and a kill. Abby Hall, it's 19-10 now, Lancaster with the lead.
Some good hustle there by Cassidy Mortensen for Lancaster.
Serve here by Ashcroft. Played up front by Bibb. And then a kill for Binkley. That's 20-10, Lancaster. So Keaton Binkley with the serve. And that is
actually, however you want to look at it.
There's a little bit of a mix-up on the substitutions here. I'm not sure, but they finally got everything figured out.
Weatherholt back into the game for New Covenant.
So, Caton Binkley with her jump serve. Turned out front. Good return from that back row by Weatherholt, but finally tipped down. That's 22-10, the lead for Lancaster. As Emma Collins checks in for New Covenant. Jump serve here. Played back across. Now, set up front. That was deflected. Bibb back near side. And a kill for Keaton Tucker. It's 23-10 Lancaster.
Number 13, Rebecca Pinker coming in. I'll get it out in a second for New Covenant.
Well, you know what? We'll be broadcasted for like 48 straight hours. Everything starts to blend together. There's a jump serve from Binkley. That tipped across. Set over by Billy Barrett. And it's game point at 24-10 for Lancaster. So Binkley to serve here. And that is an ace in the back corner. And Lancaster wins game one, 25-10. Take a break, come back with game two here right after this brief timeout.
Before we go back to action here for this next game here, let me mention to those who are listening, if you are interested in a CA t-shirt, now would be a good time to contact your family or friend. Maybe your student athlete is here at the campus of NACA and have them drop by the store and pick up a nice NACA t-shirt. Several long sleeve t-shirts and sweatshirts, and this is the smallest number of people in the store that I've seen the whole tournament, I believe, especially today. Be a good time to come by and get some NACA apparel. So be sure to contact your family or friend that's on campus. Have them pick one of those up for you.
Well, we get game two underway. The serve from Gina Roberts for Lancaster as they took game one. And working on game two, there's an illegal hit on Emily Weatherhold. It's a 1-0 lead for Lancaster. Serve from Roberts. Now take it far side. Titchell. That hammered out of bounds by Abby Hall, and a 2-0 lead.
I believe I saw a few flames leap off of Hall that time.
That was moving pretty good. Serve here from Roberts. Played far side for Kittrell. In the middle, that deflected. Now to the outside. Good recovery by New Covenant to pump it back over. Bibb outside to Binkley, who just sets it over. Played there by Weatherholt for New Covenant. And a little bit of miscommunication. And a 2-1 lead for Lancaster.
In comes Olivia Hicks for New Covenant.
Only one senior on this New Covenant team. There's an ace for Allie Cottrell, and we're tied at two.
Wow, look at all those juniors on that roster.
Williams, Sarah Williams, is the only senior on this New Covenant roster. All the rest of these players will be back next year. There's another ace as it clips the top of the net and falls over. And a 3-2 lead down for New Covenant. And you got all kinds of stuff going on over here. You got ice, you have snacks to your left, you've got energy drinks, Kit Kats, water. Man, you are set to go. That tipped across and down. We're tied at three.
Brother, I brought extra for all of us. No Kit Kats, though. I don't know where you saw that one at.
Oh, Tic Tacs.
Tic Tacs. Oh, okay.
I wish there was Kit Kats. I would have eaten them by now if there was.
Tried to bring plenty for all of us to keep us energized for this 18-hour day.
That's true. And it has come in handy. Serve here by Caitlin Binkley. Well, set back far side. And a kill there by Caitlin Tucker. A 4-3 lead for Lancaster. And has Binkley to serve. Alright, jump serve. Played now into the back row. Pumped across there. Now a chance for Lancaster. And a kill for Caitlin Tucker. It's 5-3 Lancaster. Once again, the winner of this match advances to the Division IV championship, which immediately follows this match. So whoever wins this has a shot at the championship. A serve from Binkley, and it's an ace, and now a 6-3 lead.
Now, New Covenant came straight from downtown playing.
They did.
Now, what about Lancaster? When's the last time they played?
I can find out for you here in relatively short order.
Weatherholt in the game for New Covenant.
And this serve returned on one hit. Now a chance for Lancaster outside. And another kill for Caitlin Tucker. And it's 8-3. Let's see, Lancaster would have... Let's see, a loser of four... Hmm. I'm going to work on this for a minute. Got out of the inbounds. It was inbounds. And Ace makes it 9-3. They would have last played at 11:40 this morning. So not about the same, more or less, same time frame. A little bit earlier maybe, but not a whole lot. This tipped across the net. Still there, and now hit out of bounds. 9-4, the lead for Lancaster.
Some good defense there by New Covenant. They've got the double block going on the front line.
It's played out front, sent across. As a matter of fact, I'm looking at this schedule here, and both teams played at 11:40. Just Lancaster must have gotten done a little bit earlier. That knocked back over by New Covenant, 9-5. New Covenant was in the winner's bracket. They played essentially the semifinals and winner's bracket, lost, and now are down taking on Lancaster, who has worked their way back up in the loser's bracket.
Okay.
So Lancaster actually has probably played one more game. This hit into the net. And a 10-5 lead for Lancaster. These brackets are so difficult to try to decipher. They might have, if Lancaster might have played in the quarterfinals, as did New Covenant. I'm trying to take a look at this here. It's now 12-5, the lead for Lancaster. I think what ended up happening was Lancaster, Grace, New Covenant, and Beach Breakers were the final four in the winner's bracket. So Lancaster see if I can figure this out. So if Lancaster would have lost, I need the rest of this bracket filled in to know for sure. So it'd be one. Yeah, I need the rest of the bracket filled in because I'm missing one game here that would have filled in who played when. But at any case, there would be one, two, three. Both of these teams have played either two or three matches already today. One team for sure has played three matches. And if they keep winning out, they got to play another match after this. And if you're in the loser's bracket, which they are at the moment, they would then have to win two matches after winning this match. If you're all confused at home, you're no more confused than we are. It's basically whoever wins this match here has to win two more matches against the team from the winner's bracket in order to win the championship. So they got to win a lot of volleyball to make that happen. I was trying to figure out, I don't have all the teams filled in because games have been going on all day and we haven't gotten all those results, and I'm trying to basically guesstimate what happened, and that didn't work so well. That hit into the net on the serve by Emmy Bibb. 12-6 the lead for Lancaster. Back to serve for New Covenant is Abby Hall. Boy, there's an ace.
Wow.
That's a really nice serve from Abby Hall. Make it now 12-7, Lancaster. And that, a home run. Out of bounds.
Over center field fence. Number 7, Jenna Roberts, coming in now for Lancaster. Also number 3, Laura Hart, coming in for New Covenant.
Katie Stanley set to serve for Lancaster. Serve played up front, tipped across, still playable here. Dumped across by Stanley, and that's inbounds on that back row. 14-7 the lead for Lancaster.
Coming in for New Covenant, number 2, Abby Ashcroft.
So Katie Stanley to serve. That is played in the back row. Right there by Cowens. Set across by Cottrell. Out it comes. A little tip over there by Tucker. And now this set back across by Mortensen. And that hit out of bounds by Laura Hart. It's 15-7 Lancaster. Stanley to serve again. Returned on one hit, set back over, and straight down, 15-7 the lead for Lancaster. Yeah, they put up, it was 14-7, now it says 16-7, so somebody must have missed something somewhere. Now 17-7 on the ace from Katie Stanley. And there's a little bit of a mishit from Stanley. Looked like it hit Kaylin Brinkley in the face almost. Luckily, I think it went off the side of her hand or something when she served it, so it didn't have a whole lot of power on it. And this serve is an ace. 17-9, the lead for Lancaster. Emma Cowens to serve here for New Covenant. Serve played by Tucker. Now New Covenant another shot at it. Gillespie, they're in on that back line. So it's 17-10 Lancaster. So again, Emma Cowan serves. And set across. Now Cottrell, back near side, that hit out of bounds by Gillespie. It's 18-10 Lancaster. Serve here, a line drive from Tucker. Back row bumped across by Hart. And set over by Binkley. And good dig in the back row by Stanley. And this tipped over by Williams and put way back in the corner by Katie Stanley. It's 19-10.
Coming in for New Covenant, number 9, Abby Hall.
And Caitlin Tucker. Here to serve again for Lancaster Christian. That's into the net. 19-11 the lead for Lancaster.
We've got a question at the scorer's table right now. Looks like a discrepancy in the books. Looks like that is corrected.
Now Sarah Williams to serve. That's set across by Bibb. And that's dumped back across. And it's tipped over. Now returned out of bounds. And 19-12 the lead for Lancaster.
That looked mighty close to coming in contact with a player from New Covenant.
Serve from Williams, that returned back across, and then hitting it into the net is Abby Ashcroft. It's 20-12, Lancaster.
Coming in for New Covenant, number 13, Rebecca Pickard.
A nice serve from Cassidy Mortensen. Up front, this tipped across. And New Covenant plays it to the back row to Collins. Set far side. This played off the ceiling. And under the net it goes, so 21-12. And we have a timeout, New Covenant. 21-12 Lancaster here in game two. Back in a moment. That serve into the net, and a 21-13 lead now for Lancaster as Sarah Gillespie will serve for New Covenant. Played now up front, dumped across by Binkley, and that will eventually fall in, and it's 22-13. This is Gina Roberts to serve for Lancaster. Returned on one hit, sent right back across. Near side, that hit out of bounds. Off the hand of Abby Hall. And it's 23-13.
Coming in, number six, Olivia Hicks for New Covenant.
Santina Roberts to serve. Played up front. Tipped down and nice dig on that back line by Gillespie. Head hit out of bounds. It's 23-14.
In the game, Katie Stanley for Lancaster.
Now Allie Cottrell. The serve for New Covenant, they trail 23-14. Here comes little dink across the net by Caitlin Binkley, and it's 24-14 match point upcoming here for Lancaster. So Binkley with the jump serve. Now bumped across by Olivia Hicks. Went to the outside, that hit just out of bounds. 24-15, Lancaster leads. And now